Ladies and gentlemen, since the first library in Nineveh, 2,700 years ago, libraries have been cornerstones in the development of civilization. Libraries have evolved, but their task remains to give all citizens the widest possible access to knowledge. Access to knowledge and use of knowledge are a key theme of the digital agenda for Europe, the Commission's strategy to make every European digital. And today I will focus on access to science and culture. Researchers and engineers need to have easy and quick access to the results of science. This is not a luxury for Europe, but a must if we want to compete globally. ICT and digital infrastructures, therefore, are key. But we are facing important hurdles. Also, about 95% of scientific journals are available online. Journal subscription prices have risen 4 to 5% above inflation in recent years. That's quite a lot for research libraries to cope with at a time of limited budgets and further cuts. We cannot afford for access to scientific knowledge to become a luxury. Our vision is open access to scientific information, and that will allow us, all of us, to get the most benefit from science. For education, for innovation, and for whatever creative reuse people can think of. Publicly funded research, in particular, should be spread as widely as possible. And to show that we practice what we preach, the Commission plans to extend current open access requirements so that it covers all EU-funded research as a principle. There is already a dedicated pan-European repository infrastructure, OpenAIR, to support this. And I'm currently working to enlarge it to include scientific data as well. And we are also preparing a recommendation to member states, and this will spell out what is needed to get better teams of access to and management of scientific publications and data. Plus, research librarians have a specific role in preserving scientific records. It's no good having digital science records if we can't preserve them for future generations. And we may not always be able to predict just how much use existing data will be in the future. For example, the weather observations recorded by generations of sailors can now be used for invaluable climate research. And I'm fully aware that research libraries can't solve this problem alone. LIBER and its members already participate in several of our key projects to future-proof science records. And I sincerely hope this continues. Let me now turn to the digitization of cultural heritage. Europeana is a major driver for Europe's digital renaissance. Already the collection holds millions of objects, and more than 1,500 institutions are busy adding to it. The Europeana Libraries Best Practice Network should bring the digital collections of Europe's leading research libraries online. A full-text search will give researchers, students, and all of us a chance to reach directly into the books and other materials. That is a wonderful opportunity. But let's be even more ambitious. By 2015, I want Europeana to hold 30 million objects. By 2016, it should include all public domain masterpieces. By 2025, it should have digitized all of Europe's cultural heritage. Please continue to help me in our common quest to get all knowledge digital, accessible and reusable for the benefits of all Europeans.